Unit number 2. Unit 2 is dealing with some physical phenomena which vitally influences almost all the biochemical processes, biochemical mechanisms in a living system. This unit includes osmosis and osmotic pressure, which dictates actually movement of liquid in a body, living body. Diffusion is the movement of particle whether inside or outside a living system. Active and passive transport, transportation of molecules using a transporter protein, and also facilitated diffusion. It is diffusion using a transporter. And an example is mentioned in this chapter as glucose transporter. And also we are dealing with the colloids and Dunnan membrane equilibrium. These are some systems in the living body which are part of normal biochemical system. What is depicted here is osmosis. See here, this is a vessel. In this vessel, it is separated into two compartments using a semi-permeable membrane. It is semi-permeable because this membrane is permitting the passage of some molecules or particles across it. And you compare this diagram with this diagram. You see here, what's the difference? Here, this red colored circles or spheres represent the sugar molecule, while the other molecules, these black small dots, represent water molecules. Now, what is the difference between these two diagrams? How many molecules here? One molecule, sugar. Here also one sugar molecule. So, number of sugar molecules have no change. Here, four sugar molecules. Here, four sugar molecules. So, the sugar molecules have not migrated. Then what happens? You see here the height difference. Why this much height difference? Because where there was more solute concentration, here sugar is a solute. Where there was more solute concentration, into that direction the water molecules migrated. This migration, this movement is called osmosis. So we are going to study about this in detail. And on this diagram you can see there is a Dunnan membrane equilibrium. This is a system. Here you can see excess positive charge on one side while negative charge on the other side. These charges exist across a semi-permeable membrane. And apart from these negative charges, these spheres represent negatively charged colloid particles. So apart from these negative charges, negatively charged colloid particles are there in this side of the membrane. And these colloid particles cannot move across the membrane. You see, electrical neutrality should be maintained in a system. In order to maintain electrical neutrality, how many negative charges are there on one side, that many positive charge should be there on the other side. Here, in this picture, how equilibrium of charges can be maintained. That system, that equilibrium is called Dunnan equilibrium. And in the following slides, we will see how an equilibrium is maintained. And this is a colloidal suspension after sedimentation or centrifugation. See, concentration of the particles is more at the bottom. It is decreasing towards the top because there may be an electric field or there may be sedimentation, etc. We will see all those things in the following slides. What is osmosis? It is a tendency of water molecules to move from a region of their higher concentration of water, to the region of lower concentration of water. When the two solutions are separated by a semi-permeable membrane. When do we say that a membrane is semi-permeable? When it permits the passage of solvent particles, or we say when it permits the passage of some particle and not all particles. So for osmosis, point one, a semi-permeable membrane should be there, and point two, there should be differential concentration of solutes across the membrane. That means a concentration gradient should be there. And remember, ATP or energy is not consumed in this process. And the movement produces osmotic pressure. What better we say, the movement is actually down an osmotic pressure gradient. This pressure is measured as the force necessary to resist the movement of water. Or we say, this osmotic pressure is measured as the pressure required just to stop the flow of water. And there is a Van 't Hoff equation to measure this osmotic pressure. Osmotic pressure pi is equal to ICRT. You have heard of a universal gas equation in the chemistry lessons of your lower classes. Pi is equal to nRT, such an equation is there. This equation is almost similar to that equation, pi is equal to IC into RT, where pi is the osmotic pressure. Pi is the osmotic pressure, and R is the universal gas constant, 0.08206 liter atmosphere per mole Kelvin, and T is the absolute temperature. This is rho here. Here you should make it T. T is the absolute temperature. Then what is IC? IC is the osmolarity of the solution. IC is the osmolarity of the solution. In your higher secondary classes, when you studied the chapter of kidney and the renal function, you must have studied in the renal tubules, there are different regions of different osmolarity. That osmolarity is mentioned here. Osmolarity is the product of the solute's molar concentration. So here C is the concentration of the solute in moles. Molar concentration C, and the Van 't Hoff factor I. What is I? I is the Van 't Hoff factor. And this Van 't Hoff factor is a measure of the extent to which the solute dissociates into different ions. Let us explain this in more detail. So don't forget, pi is equal to ICRT. You see, what is I? Let us come back to I. I is the number of different ions produced by one solute particle. For example, you should add sodium chloride, table salt into water, I is equal to 2. Why? 1 mole of sodium chloride dissociates into 1 mole of sodium ions and 1 mole of chloride ions. So how many particles are produced from one unionized particle? 2 particles. That's why we say I is equal to 2. On the other hand, if you take the case of glucose or fructose, there I is equal to 1. Why? These solutes are not ionizable. In your tea and coffee, you are adding sucrose. After adding sucrose, what is the value of I? I is equal to 1. Why? Because sucrose does not ionize into different particles. So remember, this I indicates the number of different ions produced by the dissociation of one particle or one molecule of the unionized solute. I think now it is clear to you. So let us explain more. Pi is equal to IC into RT. It is equal to I1C1 plus I2C2, like that. You know, for example, if a solution contains different types of solutes, then the osmotic pressure depends upon the sum total of osmolarity of each of the solutes. The final osmotic pressure depends upon the sum total of osmolarity of each of the solutes. Now I think it is clear. We may also say C is the concentration of solutes in moles, so pi is equal to I into mRT. Here this is a diagrammatic representation, figure 212. Try to find out from which textbook this figure is taken. Remember, all the data I show in the slides is taken from some textbook or some website. You may try to find out which are these textbooks. That way you can get more notes from these textbooks. You have this textbook with you. I have given it to you. You see, in this beaker there is pure water and there is a non-permeant solute dissolved in water in this vessel. This membrane is semi-permeable. Non-permeant solute means this solute cannot go into water. Non-permeable solute means this solute cannot go into water. So to maintain osmotic pressure, what should happen there? Water should enter inside, because this membrane permits only the passage of water and not the passage of solute. Result, what happens? You see, the level of liquid increases in the vessel. Level of liquid increases by what height? You can see the height is mentioned here. And how do we measure osmotic pressure? You see, osmotic pressure is the pressure with which water is entering into the system. Osmotic pressure is the pressure with which water is entering into the system, but we cannot measure it directly. Then how can we measure it? We will use a piston. In this diagram you can see a piston is present, and at the end of the piston a meter can be applied, meter can be fixed. Then we are applying pressure in the opposite direction. We are applying pressure in the opposite direction until the upward entry of water is just stopped, and we take the reading on the meter. That reading is expressed as osmotic pressure. So what is osmotic pressure? It is the pressure required just to prevent the entry of water by osmosis into this system. Osmotic pressure is the pressure with which water is entering into the system, but we cannot measure it as such. Instead, we are measuring it as the force required just to stop the entry of water into the system. That is why we are using a piston and a meter attached with it. A pressure meter can be attached with it. That is how we estimate osmotic pressure in a system. And in a living system, different compartments are there, different cells are there. In a cell, different compartments, for example, organelles are there. Sometimes within an organelle, different compartment may be there. And we often compare the osmotic pressure of different compartments. Let us consider a cell and its surrounding solution. Just consider a cell is taken into water present in a beaker or present outside the cell. Let us consider like that. So there are two compartments. One is the cell containing the cytoplasm. The other is the water in which the cell is present. The cell is said to be isotonic. When both have same osmolarity. When the osmotic pressure of the cytoplasm is the same as that of the water outside, we say these solutions are isotonic. Iso means same, similar. On the other hand, a solution having more osmolarity than another one is said to be hypertonic. What does it mean, hypertonic? A solution is said to be hypertonic when it has more osmolarity compared with the surrounding solution. For example, if the cytoplasm has more solute concentration, it has more osmolarity and therefore it is hypertonic compared with the outer solution. On the other hand, what is hypotonic? A solution is said to be hypotonic when its osmotic concentration is lower compared to the surrounding or the nearby solution. So remember, a hypertonic solution has more solute concentration while a hypotonic solution has lower solute concentration. So don't forget it. This is a very important parameter. In our body, water moves from cell to cell based on their osmotic concentration. You see, if you are keeping a cell in a hypertonic solution, what happens? Water moves from where it is in higher concentration to where it is in lower concentration. So the solution is hypertonic, means that its water concentration is lesser and solute concentration is more. So what happens? The cell has more concentration of water and therefore water moves out of the cell into the external solution and the cell shrinks. And in a hypotonic solution, water enters into the cell and it swells, because concentration of water is lower inside the cell, it is higher outside the cell, so water moves from outside the cell into the cell. Actually, you have studied this topic in your higher secondary biology classes. There you used another term. You used a symbol like this for that. What is it? You used such a symbol for this. When you used psi s, you called it solute potential. When you used psi w, you used the term water potential. Here also the same principle is applied. Water potential is more in a hypotonic solution when the concentration of water is more. Water potential is lesser in a hypertonic solution when the concentration of solute is more, or we say when the concentration of water is less. So water moves from a region of higher water potential to the region of lower water potential until water potential becomes equal in both these solutions. I think now the topic is clear to you. When the water potential of both the solutions is equal, what do we say? We say the solutions are isotonic in nature. And when the osmotic lysis actually take place, you see, in natural environment, cells generally contain higher concentration of biomolecules and ions. You see, in our body also, our cells contain more biomolecules and ions, or there is a higher concentration of biomolecules and ions in our cells than the surrounding liquids. Therefore, what happens? Osmotic pressure tends to drive water into the cells. Remember, if the cells don't have a cell wall, as is the case of animal cells, this inward movement of water will result in an expansion of the cell membrane. But remember, the plasma membranes are not elastic in nature, so the cell will bulge, and finally the cell will burst. Animal cell can burst. That's why if there is a shortage of fluid in your body, the doctor or the nurse is injecting saline water, which is isotonic to the human cells. Do you believe that we can inject pure distilled water? What will happen if a large amount of distilled water is injected into your body? Just imagine. But the same thing is not going to happen in a plant cell. Why? Plant cells are provided with a cell wall. The cell walls are rigid structures that can prevent the expansion of the plasma membrane. The same thing is explained here in this diagram. You see, this is a cell. This is the solute inside the cell. this medium outside is shown here. This is the medium outside. Here the cell is placed in hypertonic solution. Hypertonic solution means here there is more solute. That means there is lower water potential here. Water potential outside the medium is low. What happens? Water moves from the region of higher water potential to the region of lower water potential, and the cell shrinks. While the other case is this, the cell is placed in a hypotonic solution, which means outside the cell there is a higher water potential. There is a higher water potential outside the cell. What happens? Water moves from the region of higher water potential to the region of lower water potential. Ultimately, the cell will expand because of the outward pressure. This is the moving water, and this is the expansion of the cell membrane. And eventually, if there is no cell wall, or if there is no structure to prevent the expansion of the membrane, the cell will burst. And now we are going to see the mechanisms evolved to prevent osmotic lysis in the next slide.